About NoMagic, incremental load of your SAP data into NIME. So we would start now the webinar. My name is Koder Elzain. I'm responsible for product management and pre-sales at Theobald Software. Today I'm joined by Tobias Kötter, responsible for product management at our partner NIME. Tobias, would you like to introduce yourself?
Yeah, just thanks a lot, Koder, for the introduction and also for organizing the webinar. And I'm happy to be here. Thanks.
Thank you, Tobias. So if we check again the agenda, so I would make a smart introduction. Then I would start with our part from Theobald Software. We would offer a product overview. Then we would talk about the possibility of delta load from SAP systems and give you a live data with our product Extract Universal, how you would extract the data. The part two is about NIME, and that would be done by Tobias, who will give again a product overview about NIME and show the SAP data extraction and delta load extraction in a live demo directly in NIME. That all should take about 45 minutes. And then we should have at the end about 15 minutes for your questions and for a discussion. In the tool, you have a chat window where you can, the possibility to write your question there, and then we would discuss and answer all your questions. So you are welcome to write your questions there. Let me start with a small introduction about Theobald Software. So as a company, it has been founded in 2004. We are a software company specialized in the development of SAP integration and SAP connectors. We offer different SAP connectors in different areas. Today, we would focus just on one product. We have about 3,000 SAP customers worldwide, including customers from all sizes, from all industries, and who are using our products for different SAP integration scenarios and so far. We work in general also with partners. At one side, we have technology partnerships, like for example with SAP, where we are a partner, where we have certified our product. We also work with technology companies like NIME, in this case, to improve the integration between the different tools. Ensure we have partners for implementing and supporting customers in their projects and so far. We are headquartered in Stuttgart, Germany, but we have a location also in different countries, for example, in Seattle, USA, in Paris, French, and in China and Hong Kong. Just to be near to the market, to the partner, to the customers, and so far. And on the right side, you see how our customers are distributed worldwide so far. And that was a short overview about the companies. Here, I would give you some references, just some of our customers. As you see here, companies in general from all industries, so we are not restricted to a specific industry or to a specific SAP module, for example, and our companies really come from all sizes. If you'd like to see more references, you can check that on our website, sure, or come back to us. So as I've told you, we are a software company. We offer different SAP connectors for different area. I would focus today just on one area, just on one product. And the product that we'd like to talk about is called Extract Universal, that you see here in the architecture. So what is Extract Universal? Extract Universal is an SAP extractor that helps you extract your SAP data and bring it into different environments. As a tool, it would be installed and it would run on any standard Windows environment. You install it just there and configure it. It's just a matter of minutes, or maybe hours, but not days or weeks. So you would just install it. You would connect to your SAP systems. As you see, SAP systems, it can be in a classical ERP ECC system or the newer version, S/4HANA, for example. Ensure if you have the business warehouse or the business warehouse for HANA, the newer version, that's also supported. And technically, any SAP system in the business suite, that can be, for example, SAP CRM, SRM, and so far, is supported too. And our tool is, in general, would connect always to the SAP application server, where your business data, where your business processes are running. And we would not connect directly to a database. So that has different advantages for you in this case. And technically, the SAP system can be hosted on-prem, as it is in most cases. But for example, even if it is running on the cloud, and so far it's supported. As far as RFC connectivity is supported. RFC, that is the protocol that is used here to connect to the SAP system. So again, on the SAP system, you have different objects that can be extracted. And for the different objects, we offer different components. As you see here, we offer different components, and with those components, you would be able to extract all possible source objects from your SAP system. So you would be able to extract data with the table component, for example, from tables and from views. You can extract data from SAP function modules and SAP BARPI. You can extract data from the SAP or ERP query, from the ABAP reports and ABAP programs. You can extract data from the SAP business content, either using the DeltaQ component or using the modern and new ODP framework. And for the case where you would like to extract data from a business warehouse, again, the ODP framework can be used for that. You can also extract data from your multidimensional objects like Hube or from your batch queries and so far, ensure hierarchies or open hub destinations are also supported so far. So again, you see you have components to extract all possible source objects from all possible SAP source systems. Yeah? And then the next step would be to define your destination, where you'd like to load the data into. Here you see just some examples. That can be a database or a data warehouse that's running either on-prem or in the cloud. That can be cloud storage, for example, Microsoft Azure or Amazon S3, for example, or Google Cloud Platform. If you would like to have your data there, maybe for big data scenarios or for machine learning scenarios and so far. Ensure data can be also extracted and provided for different BI and analytics tools. And we would talk today especially about that integration with NIME. So here again, we see the scenario that we are focusing on today. We would provide that data to NIME. We would also focus today on the topic about extracting data from SAP in Delta mode or in incremental mode. There are two options that are supported. The first one would be, for example, using extractors or data sources. In general, the extractors and data sources are part of the so-called business content that is in general delivered with the SAP system. That business content is in general used to transport data from an ECC or an S4HANA system to BW system or a BW4HANA system. Yeah? And with our tool, you can extract that data from that business content. That business content or that, those extractors offer different advantages. The first one would be that they provide a business view on your data. Yeah, so that means the data that is offered there is for usage in BI scenarios in general. And the second benefit would be that it provide a built-in mechanism to deliver data in a delta mode or an incremental mode. We would focus today on extracting data from extractors using the ODP framework. So ODP framework is the newest framework in SAP for SAP integration. But using the ODP framework, you would be able to extract data not only from extractors and business content, but from other objects, like, for example, CDS views, or if you are extracting data from in the business warehouse system, so you can extract the data from the business warehouse systems, different providers or Cube. So that would be one scenario that would talk about, and we would see that in a live demo later. That would be using the extractor to extract data using the built-in delta load. The second scenario to extract data in incremental load or in delta load would be to extract data from example given tables or views in SAP system. For that, we would use our table component. On the SAP system, you have the table or the view that would be the source object. And to implement the delta load, we would use a dynamic filter. A dynamic filter is in general based on a specific field in the table. For example, it would be a date field or timestamp field. We would see today an example about creation date. Yeah, so we would filter based on the creation date. We can do that on with just one table. Yeah, so would if you like to extract data from just one table, that's possible. But it's possible also to join different tables, because you may know in SAP data can be distributed over different tables. If we talk about, for example, header and item data, that would be one option. We would see today an example about sales data. So sales data in general, sales documents, so are in general in two tables. We have one table for the sales document header, and the other table would be for the sales document items or position. That would be one option. But also master tables or master data in general are distributed over different tables. That would be also an option that we can join that data from different tables, and with such date fields or timestamp fields, just create the dynamic filter and just get the delta load. Another option would be using the log tables in SAP to check which data has been changed, which data has been created, and that all based again on such date or timestamp fields and the log tables. And as I've told you, to join data between two tables, we offer two options for that. Either we can join data from two tables, that means we get columns from two tables, or we make a sub-select. Sub-select, that means we get columns from one table, but based on criteria in other tables. So different options are here today. We would focus on just one. We would see, for example, here extracting data from sales orders, on that based on creation date. Okay, that was so far about the architecture of extracting reversal and about the possibility to extract data in delta load. Now I would switch to Extract Universal to show you that in a live demo. So here, okay, let me switch directly to the environment where we have the NIME server tool. So here, as you see, I have my Extract Universal. Let me here start the designer. So in general, you have the designer where you connect to the server. And when you connect to the server, you have here different options. One option would be at first to define the connections. So here I would define my connections to the SAP system. So as you see here, you can define connection to different SAP systems. For a connection, you would define here your application server, and you need some other information, and you always need an SAP user with the right access rights and so forth. So for this scenario, we have here a successful connection, that's fine. And as you see here, you can define different connections, either to the same SAP systems or to different SAP systems. That all is based on your scenario. After defining the connection to the source SAP system, you would define a connection to your destination. So again, here you just click on add, and here you see the list of the supported destinations. As I've told you, you can connect to databases, you can connect to cloud storage, you can connect different BI tools and so far. And for example, in our scenario with NIME today, we would use this destination here. That means technically just offering the data as a web service in CSV format. And that is for the integration with NIME. That's fine. Okay, when that's done, then you would here, for example, click on you to create new extraction. We have prepared some extraction. I will show you that. Let's start here with creating a new extraction. At first, we would select here the source object or the source SAP system. So I would connect, for example, to an ERP system. As you see here, we have the different components. I would start here with extracting data from a table. And let me say here, let's just call it demo sales order header data, for example. And let's say OK. Now I can search directly on the SAP system. For my scenario, I would here, for example, search for this table that contains. Okay, I think that is here the right name, sorry. Okay, that is here the table for the sales document header data. So I just click here on OK. And then here you see I have all the fields. I have here the possibility to select the columns. I see here the column name. I see some technical information about the columns, for example, which columns are part of the key and so far. And I have different options. I can here check the count of rows. How many rows do I have in this table? For example, here, as you see, about 12,000 rows. I can make here a live preview, and I can create filter. For example, as you see here, I have here a colon for this field that is here the creation date, and I can, for example, here create a filter on that. So I have different options. So I can set it here, for example, manually. So in this case, let's check all the columns that are created after yesterday. So if we check here, okay, so you see here the number of rows or sales documents that have been created after yesterday, and I can here check the number of rows. That would be one option. The other option would be to make that dynamic. That means here I create a variable. So I call the variable here, let's call it creation date. And let's say no, okay. Okay, so let's check that here. So here we have again the extraction that we have created. We are using the table component. We are using this connection to the SAP system. We are using here this default destination that is used for the integration with NIME. And if I click now on the run field, as you see here, I have here the custom tab. In the custom tab, I have the variable that we have defined. You would see that here again in the URL. And now I can here just that set the value to use it. So again, let's check it here. Okay. So let's say, for example, run in browser. So I can run that in browser as it is a web service in this case. Okay, it's not so easy to understand at the moment, but I get here the data. Yeah. Okay, so that would be here one option that we would use. So again, what we have done is we have created an extract based on the SAP table, and we have created here a where clause, a dynamic where clause. And in the next demo with Tobias, we will see how we can use that dynamically directly in NIME. Okay, that was the first option. The second option would be to extract data from a business content extractor using the ODP framework. And here again, let me create a new extraction. Let me use here this SAP system. Let me call it again demo sales order. Again, header, but in this case, incremental. Yeah. And in this case, I would use another component. I would use here this component, the ODP component. So with the ODP component, now I can search for an extractor or data source. And in this case, for example, let me here. Let me search for the sales document again. And as you see here, I have different options. So either the header data or the item data. Yeah. Let me take maybe here the item data in this case, and let's say now, okay. Okay, and so here now, as you see, I have here again all the columns available. I can again here create a filter. For example, if I would like to filter on specific years, specific product categories, and so forth, that all is possible. But the big benefit that we have here is that built-in update mode. Yeah, update mode here, as you see, so we have the full update mode. That means in this case, we are extracting all the data, no delta or update mode, and delta is required. The other option would be here, delta update, that we would focus about. And we, when we just select this option here, that means the SAP system would deliver the data always in incremental mode. The SAP system has an internal queue to check which data has been changed, which data would be delivered, and so far. Okay, I have prepared such an extraction for us. So let's say here, just okay. And let me check here again, which extractions do I have? Okay, so as you see here, I have again here that ODP framework. Let me show you that. So that is the same extractor, that is here used in the Delta update mode. And we have here the so-called active subscription. That is here the name of that, as you see. And that means that this extractor, this data has been initialized. That means we have run that for one time, we have got some data, and now it is ready to deliver the data in update mode. What does it mean? If I go now, for example, and run it, I would get the data in incremental mode. I have different options. I can do that here, for example, in extraction reversal, and I can run it, for example, directly in browser. Yeah. Let me do that. Okay, I have run this. I would like to run this one here. It's optional, yeah? The ODP one, that's important. Okay, so run that in browser. And check. Okay, that's fine. That means if we go here again and refresh, so we see zero rows. That means there is no changes on the SAP system. There are no new rows. That's fine. I can change that. I can go now here to my SAP system. Okay, and now let me create it a new order. Sorry, to create a new order, I have to go here. Okay, let me create a new order. Let me select here some information. I need the sales organization, distribution channel, division, and so far. Okay, and let me here see the value that I need them. So for example, this one here. Okay, that's fine. I have to set here the payment term and so far, and then I have to set here the material, for example, for this order. Let me select this one here. Let me select the quantity, for example, 20. Say okay. And that was it. And let's click now on okay. Okay, so now we have created a new order. As you see, that is here the number that ends with 126. And now when we run that, then we go here and we run that again here in the incremental mode, we would see that that item delivered from the SAP system without any other setting, since we have here for that here the default setting. Okay, that was so far from my part. I would switch now to Tobias, because Tobias has also prepared a demo for us and would show us that directly in NIME. Okay, Tobias, I hope you are still here. Make you a presenter.
Yeah, that would be great. Thanks.
Okay, let me see. Make presenter. Okay, please try that.
Yeah. Okay, so you should see the PowerPoint presentation, right?
Yes.
Awesome. That. Okay, cool. So far you have seen all the Theobald related part with the Extract Universal server, which we at NIME use in order to get the data out of your different SAP systems. But before the demo, I just want to give you a quick introduction to NIME, the company and the software, for all of you who haven't heard about us before or don't know what NIME is about. So the NIME software ecosystem consists basically of two different programs or tools. One is the NIME Analytics platform, which is free and open source, and that allows you to do a lot of data processing, blending, transformation, data mining, modeling, and visualization. And the other part is then the NIME server that nicely then enhance the NIME Analytics platform in order to allow you to integrate then your analysis workflows into your enterprise environment. So the NIME server takes care of deploying and management of models and workflows, and also allows you to share workflows with other colleagues, for example, so a lot of collaboration options there, and also allows you to execute workflows on a schedule and also execute workflows via APIs, so that other tools in your enterprise environment can then leverage the power of the NIME workflows, basically. And what is a workflow? So you will hear that a lot. So a workflow in NIME is basically it consists of different nodes where each node performs different tasks on the data. So here, for example, there's a group by node. So this one aggregates the incoming data table by the columns you have selected and then computes the average, the sum, or whatever you want on the different columns. Then if you combine then these workflows, these nodes together into a workflow, which then models the data flow. So the data flows from the left to the right in this flow. So here we read in an Excel file, then we attach some color to the rows, we partition the data, we learn a decision tree on the one hand, on the one partition, and on the second partition, we then do a prediction. And then afterwards we use the scorer in order to evaluate the quality of the model. And once we are happy with that, then we can also write that model out into a PML format, for example, and then use that in another workflow for prediction. And you can always have to look at the data, but I will show that in the meantime, in the demo later. And yeah, And then if you have sub-workflows that you like and want to share with your colleagues, similar to a macro, for example, or something like this, you can do that using components. And these components allow you then to expose only certain features of the sub-workflow to your colleagues, like the setting for the partitioning node, for example, or the setting which column should be used for learning the decision tree learner, for example. But all the details, like there's a partitioning node and the learner node and everything, that's all hidden within this component. And these components can be shared via the NIME server, then allowing you to build your own little building blocks that you can use then to make it much easier for your colleagues or for yourself to build complex workflows in NIME. So NIME covers the whole all stages of the data science life cycle. So from data access to transformation. So there are a lot of nodes that allow you to massage your data to bring it into the right format, because usually most of the work is spent on this task to get the data clean. And once you have the data clean, then you can use a lot of built-in machine learning models from classification, clustering, regression, all the different variations basically. And of course, you can also visualize the data with NIME. So there you have different views available that allow you to get an idea of what's in your data basically. And once you have learned the model or you have massaged the data into the right format, then you can deploy that data to different systems like BI tools, like Tableau, Power BI or something like this, or Spotfire, or write it into a database, or you can also write then a file again for an Excel file, for example. In addition to that, NIME also allows you to orchestrate your big data platform. So if you're having a big data cluster or having something like an Elastic MapReduce cluster on the cloud or on Google DataProc cluster or on Azure HD Insight or Databricks environment where you can run Spark processes, all of this you can do also with the NIME, and you don't need to code anything. So it's all like visual assembling of the workflow, and the nodes provide you with nice interfaces in order to set the parameters and tell NIME what to do basically. So NIME allows you this mixing and matching of data sources, technologies, and execution. So you can read data from a lot of different external data sources. You can read in SAS files. You can read in data from MongoDB, DynamoDB, all different relational databases like Oracle, SQL Server. You can reach out to Salesforce, or of course use the Theobald connector to reach out to SAP. You can also read a lot of different files like Excel, XML, JSON, whatnot, so all these kind of things. You can connect to reporting tools, as I mentioned before, Tableau, Spotfire, and so on. We also provide very sophisticated machine learning, like you can learn neural networks, for example, using TensorFlow. We integrate also with H2O so that you have this, that you don't need to take care of parameter optimization or anything. So that can be taken off by H2O, for example. And as I mentioned before, you can do that all in a distributed fashion on your big data so that the heavy lifting is basically done by your big data cluster and not by NIME that is running on your laptop. But NIME is only orchestrating then the huge compute power of your Databricks cluster or any other Hadoop cluster in the cloud. And you always have the option to use scripting languages. So if you miss some functionality or want to use the latest hyped machine learning library that is available in Python or a special statistics package in R, for example, you can do that very easily in NIME by just drag and drop a scripting node into NIME, and then NIME uses the power of Python or R there then within your environment, but you stay within NIME, and that makes it easy and also is nice for reporting and talking to colleagues about what you are doing with your data basically. So since NIME is that flexible, there are a lot of different use cases from all different areas. So NIME is also used in all industries. So we have examples for controlling marketing, production, sales, business intelligence or finance. So there's there is a lot of examples that we have also on our webpage if you want to have more details about them. What we also offer is the NIME Hub and the NIME Forum. So our community is pretty active and huge, so to speak. So if you have any question with NIME and you don't know how you can, I don't know, how you can learn a decision tree or something like this, or how to read data from a REST service, for example, or want to write to an Oracle database or something like this, then you can look at the NIME Hub that's on the left-hand side, which provides you with a nice search functionality for all the nodes, components that we have, and also the workflows. So usually you will find there something like an example workflow that shows you, okay, how to connect to REST service, for example, just search for REST. And if you don't find anything on the hub, then you can always reach out to the forum, which is pretty active, where you usually get an answer within a day at most to your questions there. Okay, so NIME in a nutshell. So what is the company? So we have offices in Europe and in the States, and we have close ties to universities and research. So that's why we have a lot of latest state-of-the-art machine learning models integrated also. We have a global partner network. So if you need any help with creating NIME workflows or integrating NIME into your environment, we have great partners that can help you to do that everywhere in the world, basically. And we have stable finances, so we have long-term funding, and we are already there for quite some time. So the company was founded in 2008, basically. As I mentioned, the NIME community is pretty active and also active since more than 10 years. So we have more than 2,000 active contributors that add functionalities like workflows, answer questions in the forum, provide components, which are these little building blocks, like sub workflows and so on. We have lots of use cases and examples, and via the forum, you also get 24/7 support, but you can buy that also from us if you want to. So the software itself, so then the NIME Analytics platform is free and open source. I mean, everybody can just download it, doesn't need to provide us with an email even if he doesn't want to. So it's a bit hard to say who is using that, but a lot of people are using that, that we know that roughly 96% of the Euro Stoxx 50 and Dow Jones industry companies use NIME. And and then the two software tools that I mentioned is the one is the NIME Analytics platform, this free and open source tool for gathering, wrangling, modeling, and visualizing your data. So there's no limitation on that. Just download it and extract it or install it on your machine, either Linux, Windows, or Mac, and just get started to get more value out of your data, basically. And once you want to integrate then your workflows that you have built and that you know they're working and they are reliable and they provide you with value, you want to integrate them into your IT environment, then you can buy the NIME server from us, which is the commercial complement to the analytics platform, which then allows you for deployment of workflows via REST service or managing of workflows also via scheduling and so on. You can share workflows then with your colleagues and having that all integrated into your IT security infrastructure and so on and so forth. Okay, so if you want to get started with NIME, you can get expert support and onboarding from us and from our partners, but usually you don't need to. Just download NIME and start using it. It's easy to learn. It's all visual programming, so to speak. And we have also a lot of nice videos on YouTube that you can see how to get started and so on. We also have a learning center, so you can have on-site training from us, and also we provide a lot of trainings in our facilities, for example, but we also provide online and self-paced learning, which is especially helpful now in this bad situation with Corona, for example. Usually we also do meetups and trainings, as I said, but due to Corona, that's mostly all virtual right now. And I already mentioned the NIME Hub, where you can search for blueprints, and the NIME Forum. And we have a global partner ecosystem so that you can get worldwide support from our certified partners there. Okay, with that, I want to show you the quick demo. Let me show you NIME. So that's basically the NIME analytics platform that you can simply download. So on the left-hand side, we have the NIME Explorer, which basically is the collection of all your workflows, which you can group into folders and so on. So these are your projects then basically. And you have created one SAP Delta Load workflow example. And then we have the node repository. So this contains the nodes that allow you to do different tasks on your data. For example, we have a lot of different reader nodes that allow you to read in data from all different data sources. Then we have database integration, for example. We have analytics so that you can do a lot of different mining models and so on. So all in all, NIME has over 2,000 or 3,000 nodes right now. So you usually find a node for everything that you want to do within NIME. And then the main thing is basically the workflow canvas that's in the middle here. So there you can simply drag and drop nodes onto the workflow if you want to work with them, and then you can connect them in order to let the data flow from the left-hand side to the right-hand side. So here in this example workflow, I have dragged and dropped the SAP Reader Theobald node basically, and pointed that to our test examples extract universal server. And then I can click on the fetch queries button here, for example, and then I see all of the queries that you have already seen in extract universal that Coda has shown you before. So here I select the sales document item, and if you only want to get the data and don't want to specify any parameters or something like this, that's all you need to do. You just click on OK, and then you can execute the node. So in this case, we get like one row because that's the one that Coda has added here. So that's the number that he has set. And then with the delta loading, you have the option to filter for the new and the old records. So that's the row filter, for example, and that's based on this RO cancel row, basically. So this one shows you then if the record is new or old, and then, for example, this one is then a new record because there is no information in this RO cancel field, basically. And then you could use then this record and write that into a database or something like this, for example. So if I then execute that node again, since it's this delta query set up in the background, now that I executed the second time, the data table is empty because there has no data changes been done on the SAP system. Okay, so that was basically the first solution, which is pretty simple and pretty straightforward. If you use this delta load functionality of extract universal, just point it to the query that you want to use and then run it. And every time you run, you get the new data that has changed in the system. But sometimes, as Coda already mentioned, that's not possible. But then you can still use NIME in order to do that. And that's the second solution down here, which is a bit more complex, but it still works pretty straightforward. So what we are doing here basically is we have a control file, and then in the control file, we read in the last processing date. So I've initialized that control file with the date that is 1st January of 1900. So this one will trigger then NIME to read all of the data that is available for this query, basically. So that would be our initial load here. So I can read in that control file that's hidden here in this component. I can also go in this one. So I can read that using the CSV reader. So that's the data in here. So that's again this 1900. And then I convert that into a flow variable. And what does that mean? The flow variable is a way. So that's here again. I have the data RDAT available as a flow variable. And the flow variable you can use in order to control any parameter that is available in a node view. So I can open the node dialog here. But before I use the flow variable, I'll show you the parameters. So So extract universal query allows you to set certain parameters, for example, the extraction parameters. So here I can say how many rows should be fetched, for example, what is the source, or I can also specify a where clause ad hoc, so to speak, which I don't want to do here now. And there are also some source parameters, but what we will do is we will use the custom parameter, and that's basically the field that Coda has specified in the predefined where clause. So this r.creator field, this one is basically filled with a value. So this is fixed here right now with the first January of 1900. And this is then sent to the extract universal used in the where clause. So right now I would get all of the records which are in this query that are greater than the 1st of January of 1900. So that would be basically all. But as I already said, I want to set that automatically. So this I can do in order to do that, I can go to this flow variables tab, which is available in all the NIME nodes. And there I can go to the custom parameters. And there I see now again this r.creator setting, which I can set then with the r.flow variable that I have created before. And here you also see the current value of this flow variable. So that's again the 1st of January 1900. So if I execute that node now, then it will go to extract universal, execute the query and say, okay, give me all the records that are older, no, that are newer than the 1900 1st of January. And that's in our dummy case, for example, that's now this 20,000 rows with 350 columns, basically. I can have a look at these by opening the output view. So here we see the data. So there are a lot of columns with a lot of missing values. These are the red ones here. We can also have a look at the column specification. So here you see the value domains and so on and so forth, and what type the data is in. And then we can do some pre-processing. So that's all hidden now in this component. So there we could do a lot of sophisticated pre-processing, like filtering or grouping, joining, whatnot, all missing value replacement, and so on and so forth, for example. And once we are happy with the data, then we can use any of the other nodes, because it's just a NIME data table right now. Any of the nodes that support NIME data tables, like writing it to a database, what I do here, for example, or write that also into a Parquet file in HDFS, for example, in order then to do modeling on this one in Spark, or can do that also locally, and so on. So here I write that now into a database. So I write all of these 20,000 rows. That's done now. And once I'm done with that, then I upload the control, update the control file. So what I do here is basically I group on the data, get the maximum data field out. So that's the 2nd of February 21. And then I simply write that out into the control file, which is next to my workflow. So the next time I execute this workflow, so now I read in the control file and have a look at it. So now it's the 2nd of February 21. If I now execute the node again, I won't get any data back, because now there has been no change in the data, and I have fetched all of the data that has been available in here. Okay, so far to the demo, and with that, I want to give back to Coda. I think we already have 3 questions in the question answer forum. Maybe we can answer them together, I guess, right?
Mm-hmm. Okay, Tobias,
do you want
thank
to
you
share
so far?
Yeah.
Let's see if we need that. Okay. Okay, I have different question. Let's start here with the first question. Oh, we have different, so many questions. Okay, let's start here.
Do you want to start with the first SAP report? Can you show an example where you can extract data from SAP report?
Okay, that sure is possible. I would say, let me share my screen, I can. For this, so let me share here. Okay, show my screen. Okay, so here again, extraction universal, as I've told you, here you can create new extraction, and for that here you can connect to your SAP system. You can here use for report this component, the above report component. And you would say, let's say demo report. And then you can search for a report directly on the SAP system. Okay, that's fine. So here you can search for that. Let me just take here the sample report that I have. So that's here some evaluation of movements, material movements per storage type. You have again report parameters. You can set that here manually. You have a variant. A variant is some pre-selection of some values in SAP that's defined. Yeah, so we can select just one. If we click here on preview, for example, you would see the raw output of that report. Yeah, so that's small report. In general, in a report, you have some table type like this one here that you would like to extract. We can do that here automatically. Just go to the settings and select this option here. Yeah. And now if I go and make a preview, so you see here I have the table output of that report. Yeah, just as a simple example, and that's all. Yeah? And now
cool.
If we check here again, so you have that here. Yeah? I would say if there are more questions, just come back to us and then we are happy to discuss that.
Okay, cool. Maybe I can take on one time question and then hand back to you. So please. There is another question, if we can schedule workflows with SAP nodes. Yes, of course you can do that. As I said, with the NIME server, and there you can schedule workflows to be executed at arbitrary time points. So that's not a problem at all. Okay, one question for you, Coder, maybe the one for connectivity and to extract the data. Is it enough with username and password or any other requirement?
Mm-hmm. So sure, to connect to an SAP system, you need an SAP user. Yeah. Any SAP user in general, you would take a technical user for production scenarios, and you need the right access rights on the SAP system. So we have seen you can extract data from tables, from extractors, from ABAP reports, and in SAP that would be defined per user. Yeah, and we have an online hub where you would find everything in detail, which access rights you need on the SAP system for which component, for which object, and so far.
Okay, there is another question. How is the control file handling deletes on the source database? How is the control file handling deletes? I don't know exactly what you mean with that, but we definitely don't delete anything in the source database. So it's only read-only access. So we only get the data from SAP, and we don't alter any data within your SAP system. So that stays all like it is. The control file is only something that you have locally on your hard disk or on the NIME server, for example, if you do that scheduled. And that file is all we change. So that's the delta file that has the date of the last record, the maximum date, basically. I think that also answers the second question with the can you write back to SAP, not with the NIME node. And I don't think you can do that with Extract Universal, right?
At the moment, not yet. Yeah, that is planned for Extract Universal. Yeah, so I think in one of the next release, that would be the possibility to write back. 90% of our customers are using Extract Universal are using that for read access. But for such scenario for write back, we have another product that can be used in combination. Yeah, so if you have that scenario, you are welcome. Contact me after the webinar and we would be happy to support you with that.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay, let me see. I assume. Mm-hmm. Let me take the next question. Mm-hmm. So the question is, before extracting a potentially very large table for the first time, can I extract metadata from SAP that tell me, for example, the size of the table I would like to extract? I think we have seen that in the demo. You can check the number of rows and so far, and sure, there are further possibility to get the metadata, column names, and so far. Yes, that's possible. If it's not clear, come back again to me or check the online help. We can discuss that.
Okay, then I have a question. Does the SAP node contain and store user credentials? That's totally up to you. So we have different ways to handle credentials at NIME. You can store them with the workflow in the node, but you don't need to do that. You can pass them also in via credential nodes, for example. I think the next is for you, Kodo, Theobald Extract IS. What is Theobald Extract IS?
Okay, yeah. I have told you at the beginning, we have different SAP connectors for different environments. One of the environment that we support is the Microsoft SQL Server and the integration services. So the integration service is just an ETL tool for the SQL Server. And ExtractIS is an embedded connector for that. Yeah. It actually supports the same features and the same components that we have seen here. There is no big difference. Yeah. So everything what you can use with Extract Universal, you can also use in ExtractIS and vice versa. Yeah. If there is any specific questions about that, come back to us again, please.
Okay, next is for me, I think, are the NIME SAP nodes free and open source? Yes, they are free and open source. So you only need to have a valid Extract Universal licensee and you are good to go. Just download the extension for NIME, search it via the NIME hub, for example, and search for SAP, and then you can start using it.
Okay, so let me take the next question.
Yep.
I need some documentation about working with Theobald, and do you provide any commercial workshops? So yes, sure, you have different options. You can just access our online help. We have an online help. We have a knowledge base with everything you need about documentation, about best practices. That's all for free. If you need more, yes, sure, we can offer a commercial workshop. We can discuss that with you. Contact us directly for that.
Okay, there's another clarification for the question. It means if data is deleted on the source database and it is read with NIME, but then it is deleted on the source, how will NIME identify that delete? That's a good question. So with the second option, with the using the control file, you won't see that, I think. But with the delta, I guess you can see that, right, Koda?
Yeah, yeah. Because we have seen we have a flag column, and that flag column that would tell you if it is a new row or if it is a changed row, and if something in SAP is deleted, that's in general a soft delete. That means you would get only deletion flag for that. Yeah, then you would get that flag that this row is deleted, and then you can process your data.
Yeah. So that was the row filter or the row splitter that I have shown you, so you can.
Yeah.
Use that field in order to identify that and then act accordingly, like using that row then and delete it in a database or something like this. Yeah. Okay, perfect.
Okay.
Okay, then the last question that I have so far is then, can we make a solution based on NIME accessible to business users who don't know how to use NIME? Okay, that's a good question. Okay. Yeah, so what you can do basically is that, so if you have people in your company, like business users that don't want to work with NIME, but they want to have more like a nice web interface or something like this, that you can do with the NIME web portal that is part of the NIME server. And this one allows you to expose certain views or data to any business user. So yeah, you can do that definitely.